Living in this world, as amazing as it can be, is also fraught with danger. We have to live with things like blizzards, drought, wildfires, flash floods, tornadoes, and hurricanes. It's a wonder how we've learned to survive. Luckily, we've developed many different things to help us either prevent, prepare for, or totally avoid these disasters. Now, as bad as all of these disasters are, our planet has one other disaster that dwarfs the rest of them in terms of danger, and that is a tsunami. These huge walls of water are generated by oceanic seismic activity, either from earthquakes or volcanoes. The displaced water from these events travel over the ocean at blistering speeds until it hits a shore, generating a huge wave that can measure over 100 feet high. While we may have a little warning that a tsunami is coming, there is nothing that can stop it. Entire communities and cities can be washed away, along with everyone in them. From Italy to Japan, here are the five most powerful tsunamis in human history. The country of Indonesia sits in an area that surrounds the Pacific Ocean known as the Ring of Fire. This is a ring of volcanoes that go around much of the ocean and are situated on the edge of the Pacific tectonic plate. One of these volcanoes is located in Indonesia on the island of Krakatoa. In 1883, the volcano erupted with enough force that the sound was heard over 1,900 miles away in Australia. But because the volcano was situated so close to the Sunda Strait, it generated a giant 120-foot tsunami that rushed through the strait, taking out 295 towns and villages throughout western Java and southern Sumatra. A total of 36,417 people perished in this area as a result of the wave. Smaller tsunamis were recorded throughout the Pacific countries, including New Zealand, Chile, and even Mexico. Although the death toll was high, could have been much worse. The wave was tall, but because it was a tsunami that was generated by a volcano instead of an earthquake, there wasn't nearly as much power behind it. Therefore, almost all of the deaths from this wave were confined to this area of Indonesia and not other countries. Tsunamis are usually synonymous with earthquakes. The most powerful earthquake in recorded history happened on May 20, 1960, just off the coast of southern Chile. Measuring at a staggering 9.5 magnitude, it shook the Earth to its core. The rupture zone alone stretched anywhere from 311 miles to 621 miles along the Chilean coast. As bad as it was, though, it didn't strike an extremely populated area and only claimed 1,655 lives in Chile. But the biggest danger was in the 82-foot tsunami that was generated. Unlike the volcanic tsunami that we just discussed, the power behind this one was enough to create 82-foot waves. Villages all along the South American coast felt effects. Other Pacific countries also felt the power. Hawaii, which is many thousands of miles away, was hit with waves that measured 30 feet. Once there, it destroyed villages and was responsible for 61 deaths. Other places that took damage were Alaska, Japan, and the Philippines. This tsunami was significant not just because it was from the most powerful earthquake ever, but because it was the first recorded global tsunami. Never before had anyone witnessed a tsunami that crossed an entire ocean in only a few hours and caused damage in another country. Yes, they have happened in the past, but this one was the catalyst which sparked intensive research. The southern tip of Italy saw Europe's most powerful and most costly earthquake in history. Around 5:20 a.m. local time on December 28, 1908, a powerful earthquake struck underneath the Strait of Messina. The body of water, which separates the island of Sicily from the province of Calabria, which is the toe of Italy. Shaking the seafloor for 20 seconds as a 7.5 magnitude quake, it generated waves that were over 40 feet high. Cities, towns, and settlements all across the coasts of Sicily and southern Calabria were destroyed, including Reggio Calabria, which was the former capital of the Calabria region, and Messina, the major port town for the island of Sicily. After everything was said and done, more than 80,000 people were killed. Many more were left homeless. Experts long believed that the tsunami was caused by seafloor displacement that was caused by the earthquake. However, later research suggested that an underwater landslide may have actually been the cause of this tragic event. Japan is notorious for being a hot zone of seismic. Its history is riddled with instances of damage and death caused by earthquakes, but none compare to the devastation that was caused by a 9.0 magnitude earthquake that struck just off the Tohoku region on March 11, 2011. The quake shook the entire region, causing fairly large amounts of destruction. However, the worst of the devastation from this quake was yet to come. A few minutes after the earthquake was felt, people looked out into the ocean with terror. A perfectly formed tsunami that measured as high as 132 feet in some places was heading straight towards them. It washed away houses, vehicles, buildings, boats, and anything else in its path. After the water subsided, over 15,500 people were dead, and an additional 450,000 were left homeless. Infrastructure was severely damaged in this area, with speculation that the damage was too great to rebuild from. The worst damage took place at the nearby Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. At first, the shock of the earthquake did some damage, but when the wave came in, it did so much that the reactor suffered a level 7 meltdown, one of only two in history. The other level 7 meltdown was Chernobyl in 1986. The radiation levels are still high in the region, and it looks as if it'll be years more before people will be able to settle the area again. The devastating force of this tsunami really can't be accurately represented. It's just too hard to comprehend. Over 120,000 buildings totally collapsed, with another almost 1 million either half collapsing or partially collapsing. In the end, the World Bank estimated the total cost of this event to be $235 billion, making it the costliest natural disaster in recorded history. The day after Christmas in 2004 saw one of the most deadly events in human history when a 9.3 magnitude earthquake struck just off the coast of Sumatra. This undersea megathrust earthquake occurred along the fault line between the Burma Plate and the Indian Plate. To date, it ranks among the strongest earthquakes to ever be felt on Earth. Displacement of the Earth caused the sea level above the epicenter to raise nearly 20 to 30 feet in a matter of seconds. This was the cause of the series of tsunamis that rocked countries along the Indian Ocean. With waves that measured over 100 feet tall, anyone in its path was doomed. 14 different countries saw the waves do damage and take lives. Entire cities looked as if they'd never even existed. The waves reached so far inland and pulled so much debris back out to sea that the actual death toll was impossible to determine. But the estimated amount of lives lost between the 14 countries is 227,898. The earthquake was not only the third largest earthquake ever recorded, it also had the longest duration of faulting ever observed, with fierce shaking that lasted between 8 and 10 minutes. The power from the earthquake was enough to alter the Earth's rotation, shortening the length of a day by 2.68 microseconds. Although it may seem a minuscule thing, something with enough power to alter the Earth itself is definitely something to be taken seriously. As far as the tsunami, it still is, to this day, the single worst tsunami in history. To put things into perspective, the tsunami was directly attributed to one fatality at Ruyels near Cape Town, South Africa. This place is 5,000 miles away from the epicenter. As we said before, Earth can be a scary place, especially when you cannot escape from impending disasters. But humanity has proven its ability to come together to help other countries and other societies recover from such tragic events. To learn more about natural disasters, be sure to click the link on screen to check out our video of the 5 worst natural disasters in history. As always, thanks for watching, and be sure to tune in next time.